Oh, they're all the way around the corner, I think. Yeah, they're all the way. Hopefully, yeah, right.
Presents this woman to this man?
Her mother, man.
Eternal God, our Father, we come in the precious name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you for this day. On this beautiful day which you have made, we shall rejoice and be glad. Father, we thank you for this woman and this man. And we are thankful that they have decided to show their love for one another by entering into the holy bonds of matrimony. We thank you for family. We thank you for friends, those who have come from far and near to witness this occasion. Father, we ask for your presence and ask that you will bless the ceremony. We pray that the union which takes place today will be pleasing in your sight. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Todd and Ginger are going to turn toward each other. Please be seated now. And people on the way out there, if you can just kind of come up so you can see better, please feel free to do that. There's even an empty chair or two here, too, that people might want to take. So I just want to make sure everybody can see as best as possible. Come in some more. There's a seat right here for somebody. I know you're gonna fight with me, but it's good. Todd and Ginger have been waiting for this day for a long time. It's finally here. And you've planned this day and have special readings that you've chosen. The first one is a reading by Thomas Kemp that's called On Love. It goes like this. Love is a mighty power, a great and complete good. Love alone lightens every burden and makes rough places smooth. It bears every hardship as though it were nothing and renders all bitterness sweet and acceptable. Nothing is sweeter than love. Nothing stronger, nothing higher, nothing wider, nothing more pleasant, nothing fuller or better in heaven on earth, for love is born of God. Love flies, runs, and leaps for joy. It is free and unrestrained. Love knows no limits, but ardently transcends all bounds. Love feels no burden, takes no account of toll, attempts things beyond its strength. Love sees nothing as impossible, for it feels able to achieve all things. It is strange and effective, while those who lack love faint and fall. Love is not fickle and sentimental, nor is it intent on vanities. Like a living flame in a burning torch, it surges and surely surmounts every obstacle. And blessed are you, Todd and Ginger. You're made to love and to be loved. That's why you're here. And all of us are here to celebrate with you, because we're so happy for you. And I bet you a lot of people here have given you a lot of advice about love and marriage, haven't they? Just tons, right? Well, it's my turn. And I call these the Beatitudes of Marriage. Just attitudes to be throughout your married life. The first you've already got going for you is just to enjoy one another. It's very obvious you two enjoy each other. You can just see it. And you got a lifetime to do that. So that's the first beatitude and one of the most important. The second one is marriage is about constant change, isn't it? Yeah, and life is too. You have to be very adaptable. I had a doctor tell me several years ago, he said, Bob, blessed are the flexible, for they should not be bent out of shape. So it's so important to be adaptable and always open to change. And the third beatitude is you have to live with the unchangeable, because no matter how hard you try, no matter how hard you try, Todd, you can't change her. And Ginger, you can't change him either. So just accept each other as you are, because that's what you fell in love with. And the fourth beatitude, forever is a long time, but you love each other so much you want to be together forever and ever, and that's awesome. So treat each other with kindness, encouragement, and challenge. And the fifth beatitude is, marital intimacy is based on a very deep trust. And that trust is fueled by constant communication. You know, in the course of a week, there are 168 hours, that's 10,080 minutes. And they've done studies of married couples, and they said most married couples only talk 17 minutes a week. Hopefully I'll talk a lot more than that. So keep the conversation going. It's so important. And the sixth beatitude is marriage is a balance of dependencies. There's sometimes you really have to lean on each other and depend on each other, like right now during the ceremony. There's other times you have to be independent and give each other space. There's other times you have to be interdependent and work like a team. So it's a balance of all those dependencies. The seventh beatitude is you might not think you can love each other any more than you do right now, but you really can't. And that's the beauty of marriage. Your love can grow, it can blossom, it can excel. You can come back to this place 10, 25 years from now, and your love will be so much deeper then than even now. So whatever you do, don't get hysterical, get historical, okay? And the last one is you can look at each other every day and just say, thanks be to God for the gift you are to each other. Then it really will be the best. And there's also three phrases that you can remember throughout your marriage. The first one, I bet you already do, is to say, I love you every day. I know my wife and I, we go back and forth. I say I love you, then she says I love you more, and then I say I love you most. We go back and forth. You all do that? And the second one is most couples don't do every day, they really should, is to say I thank you every day. It's just so easy sometimes to critique each other, but if you thank each other every day, then you always got an attitude of gratitude going on. And the third one's the hardest. You ever make a mistake or do something wrong? I know that's hard to believe, but if it happens, to be able to say I forgive you. And again, when that happens, my wife and I, we have to tell the other person three times, you were right. So I love you, I thank you, and I forgive you. I had a wedding probably about a year ago, and I asked his grandfather, he'd been married 60 years, and I asked him, what's the secret of marriage? He had a great answer. He said, the secret of marriage is falling in love over and over again with the same person every day, every month, and every year. And if you two do that, you're going to have a great marriage. And it really will be. But Todd, you're ready to get married, aren't you? Okay. But right before that, we're going to do a very special hand ceremony. So Todd, please hold Ginger's hands, palms up, and see the gift of life they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend. Smooth, young, and carefree, that you're holding in yours on your wedding day as you pledge your love and commitment to you all the days of your life. These are the hands that will hold you tight as you struggle in difficult times. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will comfort you when you're sick or console you when you're grieving. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will give you support as you encourage you to fulfill your dreams. These are the hands that even with a wrinkle of age will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Now, Ginger, please hold Todd's hands palms up. May see the gift of life they are to you. These are the hands of your best friend. Young and strong and vibrant with love, you that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These hands will passionately love you and treasure the years for a lifetime of happiness. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears in your eyes, tears of sorrow and tears of joy. These are the hands that will comfort you in illness and hold you when fear or grief may fill you. These are the hands that will give you support and celebrate with you in your accomplishments. These are the hands that work alongside yours as together you build your future, as you laugh and cry, as you share innermost secrets and dreams. Now join hands together. May these hands always be held by one another. Give them the strength to hold on during the storms of stress and the dark of disillusionment. Keep them tender and gentle as they nurture each other in wondrous love for one another. Help these hands to continue building a relationship rich in caring. May Todd and Ginger see their four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. We ask this in your name. Amen. My dear friends, you have come together in this beautiful space so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of us all. And so in the presence of us all, I ask you to state your intentions. I'm going to ask you three questions, and the answer is yes, okay?
Yes, go around that way.
Todd and Ginger, did you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
And do you promise to love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
And will you accept children lovingly from God?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, you have joined both hands, and now you declare consent before God and before us all. And Todd, you get to go first, okay?
All right.
I, Todd, take you, Ginger. For my lawful wife.
For my lawful wife.
To heaven to hold.
To heaven to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
Better for worse.
For richer for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
For sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Ginger, your turn. I, Ginger, take you, Todd.
I, Ginger, take you, Todd.
For my lawful husband.
For my lawful husband.
To heaven to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Todd and Ginger, you have just declared your consent before us all. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined, no one must divide. And now I think Sean's going to present the rings. He's our Lord of the Rings here, our best man. Lord, bless and consecrate Todd and Ginger in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and always remind them of their deep love for one another. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Ginger, take this ring.
Ginger, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and my fidelity.
As a sign of my love and my fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Todd, take this ring.
Todd, take this
as a sign of my love and my fidelity.
As a sign of my love and my fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And now a special blessing. Todd and Ginger, our best wishes go forward from this day with you. We wish for you a fulfilling life, rich in caring and in happiness. We wish for you a gentle and peaceful life that nurtures and comforts you. We wish for you a noble life which reflects your honesty, kindness, and integrity. We wish for you an adventurous life, exploring the fullness of your own and each other's true selves. Todd and Ginger, there's a wonderful life ahead of you. Live it fully. Love its changes and choices. Let life amaze you and bring you great joy. And now, by the power vested in me by the Commonwealth of Kentucky, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Todd, you may now kiss the bride. Woo! I now introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Morris. Comfortable. I think you're going to party for next year.